Just finally, 6th of October, your boy's back. He's got his press conference today, Conor Mcgregor and Khabib.
Is it?
It's today the first
good for him.
Press conference.
Good for him. That's a good ass kicking waiting to happen. He's going to get the shit beat out of him. Like a nice ass kicking, too, because unfortunately for him, Khabib is, you see, like Povetkin, totally emotionless, and like doesn't give a shit about your antics. You know, these Europeans, you gotta get in their heads. You ever notice these guys? They're like robots, bro. They're like killer machines, these Europeans. They have no emotion, bro. They're like ice in their veins. So I'm curious to see if all the antics Conor's gonna do is gonna, when he gets no reaction from Khabib, if it's gonna make him more nervous, or if he's gonna try to pump himself up and say he got no reaction, so that means Khabib is scared, or his fans are gonna be dumb enough to believe anything he says. You know, like the same shit, you know? He's been a pretty good punching bag, though, lately. You know, he got the shit beat out of him by everybody in sparring in camp. Me, Deshaun Johnson, used to have to go easy on him. Katina and Bradley had to go easy on him. You know, I smacked him around, and he did everything he could to get me around, out of the camp. Then he got smacked around by Floyd Mayweather. Then he got smacked around by the authorities when he had himself arrested because he didn't want to fight Khabib. And now he's going to get smacked around by Khabib next month. Yo, you're a fucking pinata, bro. Think about it. You know, everybody, you ever play with a pinata? But like, you just beat the shit out of it and you get a nice prize at the end of it, right? Like, he's like the pinata for combat sports. Everybody beats the shit out of him and then gets a nice prize, too. You know? I love it. You're a fucking pinata, bro. Good luck. That's a nice ass whipping you're going to catch next month.
Give him any chance.
You got a puncher's chance. He's a puncher in MMA. I've come to thinking about this. Like, why was he such a puncher in MMA when, for the life of me, he wasn't a puncher for shit in boxing, you know, like in the gym and in the fight, everything. So I'm like, how is he such a puncher in MMA? And I've come to this conclusion. Mixed martial artists have to deal with a lot of other kinds of things coming their way, you know, a takedown, a kick, a knee, an elbow, you know, even spin punches, you know, when in boxing you can't do that. So I think, you know, when you're looking at all that, it's a little bit more difficult to be so super accurate with your punches, you know, because you're working on so many other factors, you know. So they're not as good of technicians with their punches. Conor, by MMA standards, is a pretty good technician with his punches, especially with his straight left hand. He throws it very straight down the middle, you know. I think it's from his karate background. It's not from his boxing background, because the guy can't box for shit, but he's got a pretty good karate background from what he told me himself, and some people told me as well. So I think the accuracy of the left hand is more what makes him a good puncher in mixed martial arts. Because guys in mixed martial arts are not always practicing slipping punches, they're practicing so many other things, you know. So if you're a good accurate puncher in MMA, you'll probably be a good puncher in general. I think that's what makes him a good puncher in MMA. So he's got that chance against Khabib to maybe land a clean left hand or even land a clean kick or whatnot. Khabib is a difficult guy to deal with. Here's the one thing. First of all, you got to make sure he fights on October 6th, because I'm not convinced Conor's actually going to fight out. Because Conor might be himself tired of being a pinata, you know? He might actually like to make Khabib make weight and then pull out and come up with a bullshit excuse, because, you know, Khabib has issues making weight, you know? And, you know, you make him make the weight and then you pull out at the last minute, you know? And then you say you have an injury or whatnot, you know? And you have your doctor friend make up a medical thing, too. I've seen this happen in the past with other people, you know? So I think, you might do that. But if he actually does get in there, I think his only chance is to land a big shot, you know, money shot, you know, and I think there's an opportunity for that. But he probably gets the living shit beat out of him, I'll be honest with you. He probably gets the fucking shit beat out of him. And then, like, you know, I don't know, we'll see how. Just watch for the quitting face, because he has like this quitting face he does, where he like kind of looks like a bitch, and he looks like a bitch as he's getting the shit beat out of him. I saw it in the gym. I noticed on a fight day too. Then he starts to wobble and shit on the fight, but he's got like this bitch face. So look for the bitch face. Like I want to get out of here. Somebody help me, but I have no way out of this fucking thing. You know, like so. Hey, we're on the internet. Don't worry. It's not Scott.
Raw and uncut here.
So, see, I'm making a bad impression on my Sky colleagues.
This is the altercation in Vegas that you had.
Which one?
After the media arrivals.
Oh, from Conor?
With Conor.
Yeah.
Have you seen him since?
No, I haven't. You know, I haven't. But I'll tell, as you can see, I have no problem telling to his face he's got no balls and he's a pussy. You know, it's up to him to do something about it. You know, like, I don't have to do anything about it. I smacked him around in the gym. He got so mad, the poor guy. He got so mad. I feel bad for him, you know? Don't you feel bad for him? He's talking. Like, you see, like, I address him when you talk about it. You know, I have no problem addressing it, throwing venom, you know, talking shit, you know, having fun with it, Like, this guy just, like, is in his house just thinking about me. I leave this interview, I'm thinking about the AJ fight. I'm hanging out. I'm thinking about what I'm going to do next. This guy thinks about me. Posts me on Twitter. Posts me in his documentary. I haven't seen him, no. I do think, though, these things did affect him, for him to think about me. Because if I would have known I would have affected him this bad, I wouldn't have fucked with him, you know? I would have left him alone. I would have let him be, you know? Like, after a year, if you're still thinking about me, I feel bad for you. I feel bad. It hurts me because, you know, what do you have, two kids since then? Or, I don't know, we had two chicks pregnant. I don't know what happened to the other one. Like, so all of a sudden, they stopped talking about her in the media. Yeah, so his wife had the kid. I don't know if the other chick had the kid. So you had two kids. You caught an ass whipping, a few. You made $100 million. I don't know how much Dana raped you for it, but you made $100 million. And, you know, you did all that, and then you're still thinking about Paulie Malignaggi. I don't know, bro. I would have left him alone. Had I known this, I would have left him alone. Poor bastard. At least he made the money. What about his fans? They got to live with me just talking shit. It's poor bastards.
Paulie Malignaggi, always a pleasure talking to you, my man.
All right. And if you still haven't figured out this guy's a pussy, he's coming because you're a pussy. That's probably what it is.
Paulie Malignaggi for FightHype.com. Thank you very much.
And let's hope for no rain Saturday, please. No rain. Come on.
There's a man behind you. Let's see if he knows.
Let's pray. Let's pray no rain.
Thank you, brother.